All right, here we are on the play. Yeah, this hand's excellent. Cast Viscera Seer and Malira, and then we just have to draw a Finxer or a red cap to go off. And it has, like, a Witness, which is a good card, so I'm definitely willing to keep. All right. Our opponent mulled the six. We'll lead off with Viscera Seer. Without any specific information, I think it's worth shocking ourselves to play it on turn one. If we knew what he was playing, there's, like, a chance we wouldn't, but. So either Jund or Burn would be my guess here. Revelark Witness is also just super powerful if they don't have a way to shut it down over a grindy game, can really take things over. Like he's a Living End. Okay. This matchup's really good because they can't really beat a Viscera Seer. You just sacrifice your whole board in response to them going off, and then they can't win, is the usual plan. So I think, yeah, I'm not going to sack anything. Might have been worth considering sacking Malira there, but I don't think it is. So we'll play Pontiff plus our team, hit for five, and then be prepared for him to go off. Plus one the team, take five. Right. So he'll go get himself a forest. Yeah, so the main way that you lose in this spot is when they have Fairy Macabre. So I'm just gonna play Eternal Witness. I guess I could fetch first, you know, whatever. I don't really care about that benefit. Yeah, let's get a swamp. Guess we'll attack, probably get Living Ended here. And then we'll play Eternal Witness. No, just gonna take four. Sure. So now I get a little added benefit. The fact that Witness is going to return to play means that I don't necessarily have to sacrifice exactly all of my creatures, because we know we can get something back with Witness. So that's pretty convenient. And our opponent is setting himself up so that he has to go for it next turn. He really has no choice at this point, and we just have to find a red cap or a Finx, and we'll win. To that end, I'm going to be sacrificing Witness and Pontiff on his end step, because if we find one of those creatures, we can force him to go for it immediately. And I get extra scries that way before my draw step, which is could be relevant. All right, so he doesn't even have a land drop, which is a little bit surprising. I assume if he didn't have a Living End spell, he or if he didn't have a Cascade, an instant speed Cascade, he would have just scooped. So we're gonna do Pontiff first because we want to leave the Pontiff in the graveyard, which only happens if you sacrifice the creature that it was targeting with Haunt. So we can do it that way. This also gives us the potential to find Cord, which we can just kill him with at instant speed. All right, Deathrite is sometimes good, but not what we're looking for here. So we basically have 10 cards to hit, theoretically. I guess pod, so 14. We get basically three redraws to our 14 outer. Ah, there's a pod. That'll do just fine, thank you. So I guess we'll attack first. probably has to living end here. Yep. Hopefully no Fairy Macabre. Some decks don't even play that card in main deck, so there's a chance he just doesn't even have one in his list at all. Sure, leave that on top. So now, right now, Witness would return Viscera Seer, and that would be good enough. Because then we just play Seer, pod up our guy. Yeah, that seems fine. Just let it happen. Cool. So I'd like my Viscera Seer back. I guess I'll pump my guys. Alright. I would like to witness back that. Play Seer. Play Pod. And kill you. This is fairly typical of how the matchup plays out in my experience. Just they muster up their creatures to go off, and then you go off right back because you have Seer. So there we go. All right, so sideboarding. I like Shriek Maw because you can evoke it. Abrupt Decay is clearly horrible. Spellskite is clearly horrible. Pride Mage and Harmonic Sliver are key because they often, or at least occasionally, have whatever that have Leyline, which is pretty important. Linvala doesn't do anything. I don't know how good Archangel is. Orzhov Pontiff never does anything. And I think I'll take out a Voice and then bring in these four Thought Seizes. Sin Collector might also be okay. I haven't played against Living End since I've added Sin Collector to the deck, which we did for Detroit. I don't really have another card I want to cut. Like, Archangel feels like the most suspect card, Archangel or Revelark, just because it's very hard to get to 5 mana. But...